वेलकम टू माय क्लास 12 फिजिक्स फर्स्ट चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड फील्ड्स एंड मेन पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन टुडे दैट इज टॉर्क ऑन ए डाइपोल। डाइपोल मीन्स योर इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल इन ए यूनिफॉर्म फील्ड। यूनिफॉर्म फील्ड मीन्स दैट इज यूनिफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, क्लियर। एंड योर हेडिंग इज टॉर्क ऑन ए डाइपोल इन ए यूनिफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। And uniform electric field means these are the electric field lines and all the electric field lines are parallel to each other. That means at any point magnitude of electric field always remain constant and that is the direction of the electric field. This is the direction of the electric field and you know direction of electric field it always outward from the positive charge and towards the negative charge. That means in the left hand side your positive charges are there and in the right hand side negative charges are there, so that electric field lines is starting from left side and end at right side. That means from positive to negative, clear. Then we take electric dipole. Suppose this one is the first pole. Suppose minus Q placed at point A. Minus Q charge is placed at point A. Another charge particle is there. Another point charge is there. Second charge. We write second charge, suppose plus Q. And placed at point B. And this is the distance between the two charges. We join from A to B. Simply we join from A to B. This is the distance between the two charges. And this distance we write, suppose 2L. And you know the electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment, that is a vector quantity, that is known as the P vector. And the direction of electric dipole moment is always from negative charge to positive charge. That means minus Q towards the plus Q. This is the direction of electric dipole moment. Here we write P vector. P vector means this is electric dipole moment. Clear? Then what happened? At point A, a negative charge is there, that is minus Q. So that a force is applied on minus Q charge due to the electric field. And you know, always a force is applied on this charge and this side is positive. So that a force is applied just in the opposite direction of the electric field on this minus Q charge. A force is applied just in the opposite direction of the electric field. This is the direction of the electric field. And in the opposite direction of the electric field, a force is applied. We write that force F minus vector. Force applied on negative charge. So that we write F minus vector. And you know the formula? Formula for force. Force is equal to charge multiplied by electric field. You know this formula. Clear? Similarly, here another charge is there, plus Q charge, and left hand side this is positive, so that a repulsive force is applied on this charge in the direction of the electric field. And this is the force, this is the direction of the force applied on this plus Q charge due to the electric field, and that is F plus vector. And here also formula is the same. Charge is Q and electric field is E. That means here on the first charge means minus Q charge, force applied, that is Q into E vector. On the second charge, that is plus Q charge, another force is applied, that is also Q into E vector. But here this force means force applied on plus Q charge is along the direction of electric field, so that suppose this one is positive. Similarly, force applied on minus Q charge is just in opposite direction of the electric field. That means this force is suppose negative. Clear? Then what is the total force applied? What is the net force applied on this electric dipole? We write simply net force or total force. Total force applied on electric dipole is, we write that is F total is equal to one force that is F plus vector, that is the force applied on positive charge, plus another force that is the force applied on negative charge, and this is equal to F plus. F plus means in place of F plus vector we write Q into E vector. We write that is Q into E vector plus F minus. F minus means that is the force applied on minus Q charge, and that is just in the opposite direction. So that here we put a minus sign, a negative sign, minus of Q E vector, and finally we write total force applied on the dipole is zero. Net force applied on the dipole is zero. Then what happened? Suppose a body is there. A body is there, and initially body is at rest. Initially body is at rest, and suppose a force of 10 newton is applied along this direction, and at the same time another force is applied on this body, and that force is also 10 newton along this direction. That means two forces are applied just in the opposite direction, and magnitude of the both the forces are same. Then always the body is in rest. Why? Because net force or a total force applied on this particle is zero. If total force is zero, that is known as translational equilibrium. That is known as translational equilibrium. That means if the body is initially at rest, body is always at rest because net force applied on the body is zero. And if the body moves with uniform velocity, always the body moves in uniform velocity because net force applied on the body is zero. And in this case, suppose dipole is initially at rest. If dipole is initially at rest, suppose, then net force applied, we write that is F total. Net force applied on the dipole, that is zero. If net force applied on the body is zero, that is known as translational equilibrium. That is known as translational equilibrium. That means no translational motion is there. No translational motion is there. But here, look at the figure. Here two forces are up there. One force is applied along this line. One force, that is suppose F minus. F minus is applied along this line. And at the same time, another force is there, that is F plus. F plus is applied along this line. That means both the force are applied along different line. That means different line of actions are there. Different line of actions are there, not a single line of action. And magnitude of first force, that is QE. Magnitude of the second force, that is also QE. That means magnitude of both the force are same. Magnitude of both the force are same. We write here both force are same magnitude. And the direction is opposite. Direction is opposite. That means acting in opposite direction. Acting in opposite direction with different line of action. With different line of action. If situation is just like this, that means suppose you take a body and one force is applied along this direction, same amount of force applied suppose along this direction, then the body starts to rotate. That means a couple is formed. If situation is just like this, that form a couple, clear? Then this couple produces, rotational motion. Because your two forces are there, and both the forces applied in opposite direction, and magnitude of both the force are same, and both the force applied in different line or line of action is different, then what happened? Now the dipole starts to rotate. Along this direction. In this case, dipole starts to rotate in clockwise direction. That means rotational motion is there. And for rotational motion, generally, torque is responsible. If torque is there, then the body starts to rotate about a given axis. Then what is torque? You know the meaning of torque in class 11. Torque means its symbol we write, that is tau. Tau is equal to perpendicular distance. Between two forces. Means that is F plus and F minus in this case, multiplied by magnitude of any force. That means in case of rotational motion, if we apply a force on a body, that is not sufficient to rotate the body. That means to rotate a body about a given axis, distance and also magnitude of any force, both are responsible. So that we write, that implies total torque applied. First is perpendicular distance between the two forces. And look at the figure. This is the first line of action. F plus is applied along this line. Clear? Similarly, F minus force is applied along this line. So that we draw a perpendicular from point B. On this line. And this point, we write, suppose C point. And here BC is known as the perpendicular distance. Between the direction of the two forces. First force, that is F plus, applied along this line. Second force, that is F minus, applied along this line. So that this is the perpendicular distance BC. And suppose this is the angle between direction of the electric dipole moment and the direction of the electric field, because this is the direction of electric field. And suppose this angle is equal to theta. Theta means angle between P vector and E vector. Theta is the angle between P vector and E vector. Then what is BC? This is the right angle triangle A, B, C, and from this right angle triangle, we will calculate the value of sin theta. What is sin theta? Simply write sin theta, here we write sin theta is equal to, from the figure we get sin theta is equal to front side of theta, that is BC, BC divided by AB. We write sin theta is equal to BC divided by AB. That implies, what is BC? BC is the perpendicular distance, that is AB multiplied by sin theta. That implies BC is equal to, what is AB? AB is the, AB is the distance between or separation between the dipole. And that separation, in this case, we write 2n. So that in place of AB, we write twice of L. In place of AB, we write twice of L multiplied by sin theta. Clear? That means in place of BC or perpendicular distance, we write 2L sin theta. So that here we write perpendicular distance, that is BC multiplied by magnitude of any force. Any force means magnitude of maybe F plus or F minus. That implies net torque applied, tau is equal to, in place of BC, we write twice L sin theta multiplied by F plus vector, and F plus vector, this is the magnitude of the F plus vector, that is QE. So that in place of magnitude of F plus vector, we write QE. Clear? That implies torque tau is equal to, again, you know the electric dipole moment. An electric dipole moment, you know the symbol. Symbol for electric dipole moment, that is P. And P is equal to distance between the two charge, that is 2L, multiplied by magnitude of any charge, that is Q. And in place of 2L and Q, we write electric dipole moment. And in place of this, finally we write electric dipole moment, that is P E sin theta. And this is the expression. This is the expression of net torque applied on electric dipole and in scalar form. This is in scalar form. Clear? And in vector form, because torque is a vector quantity. In vector form we write, in vector form, we write that is tau vector is equal to PE sin theta multiplied by n cap, because n cap is the unit vector, or that is the direction, direction of the torque. And in class 11, you know this formula. You know the cross product and dot product. Vector A dot vector B, you know that is AB cos theta, you know that. Similarly also know, vector A cross B vector is equal to AB sin theta multiplied by n cap. And this is in the form of A cross B. So that in place of PE sin theta n cap, we write tau vector is equal to vector P cross E vector. And this is the total torque applied on electric dipole. This is the total torque. Expression for total torque in vector form. Expression for total torque in vector form. Clear? Then what is the direction? Direction of the torque applied. Look at the figure. Here, first vector, that is P. Here, torque tau is equal to P cross E. That means cross product of two vectors is torque. And you know cross product between two vectors. Suppose we write vector A cross B is equal to another vector, that is C vector. And the direction of C vector is perpendicular to A vector and also perpendicular to B vector. You know that in class 11. Here also same thing. Direction of torque is perpendicular to P vector and perpendicular to E vector. That means perpendicular to this plane. Direction of E vector is perpendicular to this plane. And here P cross E, not E cross P. P cross E means we applied the right hand thumb rule. We put the thumb just like this. P cross E, starting from P. Suppose this is P. End point that is E. P cross E and thumb. Direction of thumb is towards the boat. So that here, direction of the torque. Direction of the torque is towards the boat. Towards the boat. And perpendicular to P vector and E vector. Clear? Then, here torque is there. Torque is there means the electric dipole starts to rotate, or rotational motion is there. No rotational equilibrium, only translational equilibrium, because net force is zero, that is a translational equilibrium. Here torque is there, so that no rotational equilibrium, rotational motion is there. Clear? Then, one special case. Suppose, first case 1, suppose theta is equal to 90 degree, theta means theta is the angle between, you know that is vector P and E vector. This is the direction of the electric field, and this is the case of a uniform electric field, because all the electric field lines are parallel to each other. And suppose this is the position. This is the position of the minus Q charge, we write that is A. And this is the position of the plus Q charge, we write suppose B. And we join from A to B. And this is the distance between the two poles. And this is the direction of the electric dipole moment P vector. Because direction of the electric dipole moment is always from negative to positive. And in this figure, this is the direction of the electric field E vector, and angle between P vector and in E vector, this is the angle. This angle is equal to 90 degree. Then what happened? If electric dipole is situated just like this, we write, if theta is equal to 90 degree, then net force or a total force is always zero. Total force is always zero. But what is the torque? What is the total torque applied? Total torque applied, you know the formula, that is P E sine theta. In place of theta, we put 90 degree. And you know the value of sine 90. Sine 90 is equal to 1. That means P E, this is the total torque applied on electric dipole. When electric dipole is perpendicular to the direction of the electric field, and this is the case of maximum. This is the case of maximum, that means maximum torque is applied. If maximum torque is applied, then the electric dipole starts to rotate. Why? Because here, look at the figure. This side is positive. This side is negative, because this is the direction of the electric field lines, always starting from positive to negative. So that a repulsive force is applied along this line, we write that is F plus vector. Similarly here, a force is applied along this line, that is force applied on the minus charge, so that the dipole now starts to rotate in clockwise direction. The electric dipole starts to rotate in clockwise direction. Clear? When theta is equal to 0, no torque is there. When theta is equal to 0, no torque is there. But if dipole makes some angle, maybe 90 degree, maybe 45 degree, torque is there. And this is the case of maximum torque. When theta is equal to 0, what happens? when theta is equal to 0, this is the situation. Another case, second special case. Case 2. Suppose theta is equal to 0 degree. And this is the direction of the electric field. We write that is E vector. Theta 0 degree means, suppose this is the position of the minus Q charge, that is A. This is the position of the plus Q charge. We write suppose B. We join from A to B. This is the distance between the electric dipole and this is the direction. This is the direction of electric dipole moment. We write P vector. And this is the direction of the E vector. That means both are parallel to each other. If theta is equal to 0 degree, we write vector P and E vector are parallel. Then, what is the total force applied? We write total force applied on this plus Q charge. On this plus Q charge, force is applied along the direction of the electric field. We write that is F plus vector. Similarly, on the minus Q charge, a force is applied just in the opposite direction. That is F minus vector. Clear? And here, total force, that is F plus vector plus F minus vector, that is zero. Always net force applied on electric dipole when placed in uniform electric field is zero. But what is the torque, total torque? We write the formula, that is P E sin theta. In place of theta, here we put 0 degree. And sin 0 is equal to 0. So that no torque, no total force. If total force is 0, total torque is 0, then the electric dipole is in translational and rotational equilibrium. Translational and rotational equilibrium. Clear? When net force is 0 and net torque is 0, then the dipole is always in equilibrium condition. This is the case of equilibrium condition. When theta is 0 degree, now this is the case of equilibrium. Equilibrium means translational equilibrium and rotational equilibrium. Suppose, this is the first position of the electric dipole. Now, suppose the dipole is disturbed through some angle. This is the another case. This is the another case, second case. Suppose this is the position of the minus Q charge. This is the position of the plus Q charge. Then what happened? Same thing. Here force is applied along this direction. Here also force is applied along this direction. Then total force is 0, but the torque is there because two forces are applied in two different lines of action so that the electric dipole starts to rotate in this direction, or the electric dipole tends to return back to its original position. Because this is the original position, always dipole prefers remain in this position. This is the original position. If initially, suppose dipole making some angle theta, suppose that may be 20 degree, 30 degree, then due to the torque applied on the dipole starts to or tends to return back to its original position. If the dipole tends to return back to its original position, this type of equilibrium is known as stable equilibrium. This is the case of stable equilibrium. Clear? That means if theta is equal to 0 or electric dipole moment and electric field both are parallel to each other, case is stable equilibrium. And another case, last case. Case third. suppose theta is equal to 180 degree. If theta is equal to 180 degree, then what happened? This is the direction of the electric field. This is the uniform electric field. And suppose this is the position of the minus Q charge, that is A. And this is the position of the plus Q charge, we write suppose B. And we join from A to B. That means minus Q to plus Q. And this is the direction. This is the direction of dipole moment, minus Q to plus Q. But this is the direction of the electric field. And the angle between electric dipole moment and electric field, that is 180 degree. And in this case, electric dipole moment and electric field, both are anti-parallel. Then what happened? Here also, if theta is equal to 180 degree, we write net force or total force. Total force applied always zero. But what is the torque or total torque? We write the formula, that is PE sine 180 degree. Sine 180 degree is equal to zero. That means net torque is zero. Finally, we get if force is zero, total force is zero, and total torque is zero, that is the case of translational and rotational equilibrium. Rotational equilibrium. Clear? This is the case of translational and rotational equilibrium, just like the previous one, just like this one. Here also, translational and rotational equilibrium when theta is equal to 0 degree, but that is stable equilibrium. And in this case also, this is the case of translational and rotational equilibrium, but this is not stable equilibrium. Why? Suppose this is the first case and the dipole suppose making some angle theta. Suppose this is, we write plus Q. This is the another pole, we write that is minus Q. And this is the angle. This angle theta may be 10 degree, 20 degree or any angle. Then what happened? A force is applied on this plus Q charge along this direction. This is the force applied on plus Q charge, always in the direction of electric field. And this is the force applied on minus Q charge. We write F minus vector. And due to these two force, the dipole now starts to rotate in this direction. That means away from the initial position. In this case, the dipole not return back to its original position. Here the dipole starts rotate away from the initial position or original position. If away from the initial position or original position, that is the case of unstable. That is the case of unstable equilibrium. Clear? And this is all about your torque applied on electric dipole when placed in a uniform electric field. And in the next class, we will discuss about dipole placed in a non-uniform electric field. And thank you.